Today's morning minute, kingdom living with edifying speech. And we read in Ephesians 4, verse 29 in the King James Version, "Let no corrupt communication proceed out of your mouth, but that which is good to the use of edifying, that it may minister grace unto the hearers." The enemy of God speaks in your ear. You need to tell them off. You need to tell them like it is. Instead, the word of the Lord says to edify, build, bless, and speak grace-favored words. Our speech is to be edifying, full of blessings, and filled with God's grace and favor to those who hear and receive it. And we read in Ephesians 4:29 in the Amplified, "Let no foul or polluting language, nor evil word, nor unwholesome or worthless talk ever come out of your mouth, but only such speech as is good and beneficial to the spiritual progress of others, as is fitting to the need and the occasion, that it may be a blessing and give grace, God's favor, to those who hear it." You can speak grace-filled words because you remember your salvation is sealed and guaranteed. You have been forgiven, so you can speak grace into others' lives just as you received grace. And we read in Ephesians 4:30 through 32 in the New Living Translation, "And do not bring sorrow to God's Holy Spirit by the way you live. Remember, He has identified you as His own, guaranteeing that you will be saved on the day of redemption. Get rid of all bitterness, rage, anger, harsh words, and slander, as well as all types of evil behavior. Instead, be kind to each other, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, just as God, through Christ, has forgiven you." We mimic and are imitators because of the Father's love for His children. When we know we are loved, it is easy to extend grace, love, and mercy to others. We read in Ephesians 5, verses 1 and 2, "Therefore be imitators of God, copy Him, and follow His example as well-beloved children. Imitate their Father. And walk in love, esteeming and delighting in one another, as Christ loved us and gave Himself up for us, a slain offering and sacrifice to God for you, so that it became a sweet fragrance." God's love and grace living in you allows you to edify others with words of grace. Go be a sweet fragrance, edifying others through God's love living in you today. Amen and amen.